Procurement Life Lessons, as shown by John Wayne.
Mr. Thomas?
That's right.
My name is DJ Giles, and this is my associate, Mr. Ezra Parker.
Howdy. This is Shortgrove.
We're out of the U.S. Army Purchasing Office at Fort Clark, and we understand you have some horses to show us.
No, I have some horses to sell you. 3,000 to be exact, and it's the best herd you'll find anywhere.
Fine. Shall we go inside? Thank you.
You're going a little fast for me. Do you mind trotting through that again?
Not at all. I said that out of 3,000 head, we might be able to find 500 or so that we can use. You know, animals that meet our specifications.
Well, I have 3,000 for sale, not 500.
Surely you don't expect us to purchase just any old horse for the United States Army.
Well, now, there just ain't any old horse in this whole herd. You'll take them all or none.
Mr. Thomas, I'm sure you're aware of the fact that times are hard.
Maybe not as hard as you think.
The Army's not that hungry for horse flesh.
This country's going through a period of reconstruction. Money is in short supply. Hmm? Who can you sell them to if not to us?
On serve for 10. Hold up a minute there.
Just for the record, what are you paying?
Top money, $25 a head.
Last month it was 35.
But this month it's $25 a head.
Well, these gentlemen have offered to take the whole barrel sight unseen. Is that correct?
That's correct, Mr. Thomas.
And what's your top offer?
$35 a head, of course.
You just bought yourself a herd. And you can tell that Max Million that he won't find better animals between Montezuma and the Canadian border.
Just a minute. You're selling horses to Maximilian in preference to your own country's army?
No, I'm selling horses for $35 in preference to $25. You two figured to make $10 a head.
Are you calling us thieves?
Well, Mr. Parker, yes. That's a pretty accurate description.
Lessons learned. Don't assume potential contractor has no other options.